Hello, welcome to another video. I am right into action here and I will talk what I will do when I am doing the background because it's going to take long this video. I'm just using this Inka Dinka Doo masking paper to punch a circle because this will be my sun. I'm going to create a sunset scenery using my distress paints, which are fluid mixed media paints. And I started with candied apple. I'm using spice marmalade, which I wasn't happy with. So I continue with carved pumpkin. And I'm just blending them one after another before they dry. You will see the colors I'm using on the screen while I'm using them anyway. And I just put that mask on my page because I want the sun to stay clear white. And that's the easiest way to do it. You will see I will blend my colors over and over, layering them one after another. Going for a sunset scenery using these red and yellowish colors that I choose to create the sunset. This video is very special because I will tell you the story. You know, I use and love Elena Zinsky art visuals, designs. I think her designs are very whimsical, very cute and full of creativity. She draws with something in mind and makes them different. So I was obsessed with making a page with toucan birds. I don't know, I was seeing them everywhere and they are so cute, and I love making animal pages. Also, I love tropical sceneries. Anyway, I just told her that I couldn't find the toucans that I love anywhere. I didn't have them, and I asked her if she could draw for me, and she really did. So thanks so much, Elena, for drawing these very cute toucans for me. They are in the shop, in her Etsy shop, as digital stamps. So please check it out. They are so, so cute. She colored them herself too. So if you buy, you will get a colored and clean uncolored versions. I'm going to color mine more in a more traditional way, but she colored hers with imagination, let's say, and untraditional ways. But that's the little story of this page. I have my personal illustrations of toucans that are super cute. I have a code to buy anything from Elena's shop with a discount for my viewers. So here is the code, UmutJune. Use it when you're checking out, and I will leave all the links down below to her shop. She also recently designed a lot of planner journal elements, tabs, image boxes, washes. So check them out as well for the planners, journalers out there. In meanwhile, I was talking, I just continued layering and blending these colors, orange, yellow and red. And I am just putting all these colors and blending with my baby wipe, which is not so wet, it's moist. And this is as close as it gets to the real look. You need to have these colors here and there as well. Just going back and forth with all the colors with my hand. And I decided to use this fluorescent red as well to make it a little bit pop. So I'm going to apply it with my hand with streaks here and there so that the background even pops more with this very bright color. I think it makes a difference and makes it really more vibrant. Because the page is a whimsical, fun, humorous page, I just want to have these elements. And after this, I'm going to do some background stamping. I took a color of red from archival ink, actually sienna, close to an orange brown. And I took this background stamp from one of Elena Zinsky stamps that Paper Artsy has. You can use whatever you want, it's just background stamping. That stamp set is super cute with the elephant as well, which I will use sometime on my channel. And these stencils are sent to me by a crafty friend, so thanks so much. I really don't know where she got them from a local shop probably. And I will use these hearts with an orange archival ink just to be at the background, almost invisible, but it will create some texture and interest. Again, it really doesn't matter. This is just for interest, so you can use whatever you have in your hand. You will see that those hearts won't show anyway. And here are my beautiful toucans, and I created this little love triangle scenery myself. I just took the digital stamps and made some speech bubbles on my computer, and I created this little thought bubbles with some sentiments inside. I created the sentiments. The toucans are Elena's, but I made up the speech myself, and I hope it's funny. I wanted it to be a little bit humorous, because when I saw these toucans, a love triangle came to my mind. As I said, I'm going to color these toucans more traditional, so I will make all the bodies pitch black. I'm using my Posca pen to do that, and here they are. And I'm going to color the little details that Elena drew with different colors to give them a pop of color over this black. So I'm using my Prismacolor pencils to color all the rest of the elements. I'm just making some shadows and light parts of those leaves using different tones of green. And I'm going to do all the beaks the same color as the toucan birds have. Yellow, orange, and a darker yellow will be how I will color them, and they will be more or less the same within the same lines. I'm just layering all these yellow, darker yellow, and darker orange to make it more realistic and have shadows and highlights. And I looked at pictures. Some toucans have these black parts on their beaks, so I'm going to only make one to make this one different, a little bit different. And I will give some red lipstick to my female toucan. And I'm going to color these white areas with a little bit light blue and darker blue to make it more interesting and give some shadow. Because if I leave it white, it will look very dull, I think, in a whimsical environment page like this. We can do whatever we want. And since the wings are black as well, I just prefer to separate them with a white gel pen, and I'm going to give some highlights to the body too to make it all cohesive and in line. And here is more or less how I will color them. I think it's enough, so I just did the rest myself, and I already cut them. I went through all the edges with my black marker to avoid the white edges where I cut them. Also for my speech bubbles too. These are thoughts, by the way. They are thinking it themselves. So no competition here. He has no chance. They are fighting for the girl. And the girl only thinks, are these all the options? And the other says, oh dear, Bermuda love triangle. I mean, you can do whatever you want with these birds. They are just so cute. And I just placed them on my notebook to be able to see how they place. And I am just drawing a big tree, actually, imagining they are on a tree on the branches. So I'm just drawing an outline of that tree myself with a pencil. So that I don't color ridiculous areas and I can't place them wherever I want. And I'm going to color this tree, paint this tree with a few colors. I'm using distress paints again. This is Rusty Hinge. It's quite easy to do a realistic looking tree in a whimsical page. I'm just following the outlines I did, and sometimes adding branches, little branches here and there myself. I think we can take out this mask now because I want the tree to go over the sun. As you see, it stayed all bright and nice, clean from all the paint. And I'm just, again, this is my first layer. I will do more layers because trees are, trees have a lot of colors in them. And this is from Paper Artsy. It's a toffee color. And I'm going to just, again, go over everything. And as you see, I'm not coloring totally that the color I used down. And I tried to use to start with a light color because maybe I make a mistake, I don't like it. It's easier to go over a lighter color than a very dark color. So it was just maybe a safety net for me. Now that I like how my tree looks, imagine it's a close-up look of a tree in front of the sun during a sunset. So I'm using this darker color to go over the branches and continue painting my tree. After this, I will be using a darker color. I really didn't make a differentiation of which brand I'm going to use. I just reached for the colors that was closer to me and the colors I liked. So this is from a brand called Lucas and it's raw amber. But raw amber is a famous color, very common traditional color, so you can find it in any brand. And I'm just using tones of brown in the end, so I don't think you should be fussed about which brand I'm using, which exact color I'm using. You can always start from a light brown and go to a darker brown, that's the idea. And as you see, I'm not covering it all now. This is for me, just to give the darker shadows and the rest stays as the highlights. And as I said, trees are not all same color. They have all these shades and highlights and variations within them. So it all makes it look more realistic. To blend it more smoothly and seamlessly, I'm sometimes spraying water, getting help from that, or using my finger. And so far, I really like how it looks. You will see later that I will be adding more and more thin branches to make it richer and to cover the page better. If this is too slow or too fast for you, you can always change the speed from the options down below. I think it's at the right bottom corner. There is a button you can click and see which speed you can use this video. And now I took a thinner brush to do some more thinner branches to complete this tree with the same color. I don't know you, but in summer I really enjoy creating tropical sceneries, like jungle sceneries. I think it gives me those vibes. I like the summer fruits, colorful animals, ocean sceneries as well. So my latest projects were probably reflective of these feelings that I get. I don't live in a tropical place, unfortunately. That would be a dream, but in my projects at least I reflect that wish. Now I took my white paint, again acrylic paint, to give the highlights to my tree. Don't be scared to use white like this because it only gives the highlights and makes it look more realistic. There are lighter parts where the light bounces off, so it's very normal to use it like this. If you don't want white, you can use a lighter beige, lighter brown, doesn't matter. I just like the contrast of this, so I went with the white. And now it's time to stick my tokens down. I'm using matte medium. After all, this dries, of course. It's easy because nothing will smudge. Everything I use is permanent. So I'm going over my tokens easily. I'm going to draw the legs myself for the ones that seems like they don't have the legs. I also stuck the speech bubbles, and they are thought bubbles, sorry. So I'm just drawing the links to these thought bubbles with a black marker I'm using. And I will give more details to my page with some stickers and flowers that I have. I have these ladybug stickers, so I'm going to stick a couple of them. I love ladybugs too. That's my other obsession. And I'm going to make a ladybug page very soon. These are some little flowers that I found in my local shop. For UK viewers, they are in Hobbycraft. I'm not sure if they still have it because it's been a long time I got them. But that's where I got them. I'm sure there are many things like this in Michael's or wherever you live. Just local craft shops have these little gems. Or you could always draw and paint. You can die cut. You can draw and cut flowers and place them, color them different colors. You can do many things as you wish. I'm just going to stick them all around. It's weird without leaves, I know, but I don't want to cover the page anymore because the background is very vivid and it goes with the toucans very beautifully. So I don't want to break that contrast and how the background looks. So I'm not going to crowd the page with leaves anymore. After all, this is a whimsical page and it doesn't all need to be so realistic. I'm using a little glue, and the colors of flowers I select is white, a lime green, and a bluish green to make another contrast with the background. I didn't select the same colors so that they stand out with the background. This is a border set from Limor Weber, and it's a very old set. But I just wanted to have a little light border, black border all around. So I'm using this. Again, you can even draw this yourself. It doesn't matter. It's a very simple drawing. And I'm using my archival ink to stamp it all around the edges. Finally, I went around all the edges with a black marker too to make sure there is a little black frame. And I call this page done. I really love these birds. I made the legs as well myself. And how vivid and colorful this page is. It was so much fun. And thanks so much again to Elena for drawing these toucans for me. You will find them again in the shop down below. Don't forget to use the coupon code for a discount. And also don't forget to subscribe to my channel, like or leave a comment if you like my videos. Thanks a lot for watching and see you next time.